EMFradio.com.
We had a meltdown.
A little bit. I don't know how much you guys caught of that, but...
I was yelling and screaming.
I did a little yelling and screaming, too. It's okay. It's all good. We still love each other.
For now.
Just for now. Or at least for the next 19 minutes.
Could be the last one, Frankie.
It could be. It could be. So, listen up. But, yeah, so back keeping going with the marijuana train, in the words of Rob Pitillo, this past week there was a press conference held by the Mass Patients Alliance demanding action on the part of the Patrick administration and the DPH to move forward with the medical marijuana licensing for dispensaries, as well as amending the law for caregivers so patients would actually have access to safe and affordable medicine. And I myself went down behalf of the jerks here and, you know, filmed the whole thing and watched it and stood there for the whole protest. And it was crazy. I mean, to see people, you know, like there was a mother there whose daughter is 5 years old, but is basically has the development of a one-year-old because she has intractable seizures. And she does not have access to safe, effective medical marijuana, you know. And we've seen now over the last, you know, few years how helpful medical marijuana can be for little children with seizures. You know, when you can do it with CBD strains where the kid's not getting high, you know, they're just getting better and they are able to develop. So they delivered a letter demanding action to the governor. We started, you know, a call campaign. The Young Jerks started a call campaign, and we've been banging the phones at the governor's office all week. I called twice this week, you know. I called once as just a citizen, and the second time I called as a journalist, and I said, you know, I'm Frank from the Young Jerks, and I want to know, you know, has the governor read the MPAA letter, and what is he going to do about it?
What'd they say?
There's nobody in the office right now. We're going to need to have someone call you back. Can we get a contact number? And so I expect Monday morning to at least have an email in my
inbox.
They
never have an answer.
And, you know
what? We can never comment. Can you comment? No. No.
No.
So we understand, though. We understand.
We understand how you feel.
I'm sorry. I can't say anything, though. Sniveling little.
And then just be like, I'm really with you. Then why don't you do something about it? But I don't have anything to do Monday morning, so I think I might just go down to the State House and ask him in person.
I know.
And then what are they going to do about that? Oh, there's nobody in the office. Then I could just stand there. Well, I'll wait. Like we held Richard Moore in his office. We quarantined him for about 3 hours one time. That was a good time. But no, I mean, that's what you have to do. You have
sometimes
to go down there and, you know, talk to these people in person, because a phone call, they can just hang up the phone. You know, they can just talk, say some nonsense and get you off of the phone.
That's true.
Speaking
people,
of that.
People want to do a protest too in a couple of weeks, which is good, but I also said the phone calls would be better, but even what you said, go down there.
Well,
go down to the State House. Ask for a meeting. MPA did that. I think they're going to do another one.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's just frustrating because I know that there are moms out there with children right now in Massachusetts that can't get certain strains. They can't get them.
No.
For the kids who are having seizures. We're watching this horrified on Facebook, like, how can we help? How can we help? How can we help? I don't even know if we can help, because I don't know if anyone has that specific strain. And the fact that they still don't have dispensaries legal, the fact that they don't allow caregiver services, that really binds people's hands. I don't give a, you know, crap what happens if, you know, not worried about the law, just actually finding these things and, you know, not getting ripped off and having the patient get helped.
Yeah.
And the law blocks it. Like, you know, you got a kid having seizures.
And they look at the kid and they say, sorry,
you
just
have
to be patient.
You
just
have
to
be patient.
You have to be patient. Her child had 20 seizures before that press conference started. Before it started. And she's supposed to be told to be patient. I mean, I'm sitting there in the room, you know, watching this woman who cares for her child so much. And is crying and asking the governor, please, please do something. We passed a law 2 years ago almost. What are you going to do? What are you going to do for my daughter? And she's just told, be patient.
I don't know.
And it's disgusting.
That is disgusting.
It's absolutely disgusting. You know, and Deval Patrick wants to ride the coattails to be, you know, the next attorney general, you know, of the United States. But what has he done for anybody? What has he done for any of these patients? You know?
Especially in this case.
Disgusting.
I don't know how he can.
Unacceptable.
I don't know how he can look at these people over and over again. Look at us all.
Nah, because he doesn't care, because it doesn't affect his daily life. And the people that vote, like, even though, you know, over 60% of the people voted in favor of this law, 60% of the people aren't medical marijuana patients, you know? There's probably 5%, 10%, you know? Maybe 20% of that actually are medical marijuana patients.
Or even using.
You know?
Yeah, even using, like, it's less than 20%.
You know?
So the majority that voted for it do not use cannabis.
And they call it a niche issue.
You know? It's not a niche. People know it's medicine, number one. And number two, it's a harmless medicine.
Yeah. With the least amount of side effects possible, you know?
For most people.
Well, exactly. And
there's
like we say all the time.
A small amount of people who are allergic to it. Just like any other substance, you can have allergic reactions. And if you have those, you stay away from it. If you have a bad time, a bad trip, as they call them, with cannabis or any other substance, whether it's peanuts or milk, you should stay away from that substance. Is what doctors say, right?
Or maybe just don't eat the whole bar. You know, like that woman over there.
Not the first time, anyway.
Oh, the first time. I should eat this whole entire brownie. That seems like a good idea.
Yeah, medicinal, too. Like, you know, top stuff. Not just
right?
Something that we might find.
You know? And then, like, marijuana made me go crazy. Well, you know, like, if you take too much aspirin, like, you can have, you know, harmful side effects. Like, you need to just be smart about it and have proper dosing and not play into these fears that, you know, oh, well, you know, people are going to be overdosing on marijuana. It's crazy. It's crazy. It's almost as if, you know, the Kevin Sabets and all of those, you know, Bill, what's the guy from the sex doctor there? Or that, he's the specialist now for addiction. Dr. Drew. Dr. Drew. You know, he's like, oh, marijuana is an extremely addictive drug, and I treat people from, like, you treat people for being addicted to marijuana? You mean, like, you talk to teenagers whose parents force them to go to your, you know, office because they're concerned about their child's marijuana use, and all of a sudden that person's a marijuana addict. Like, you're licking how high when you think, you know, you in here for some marijuana? He's like, I used to sleep for coke. You know what I mean? It's like, come on, like, let's deal in reality. And the reality is that people are suffering. This mother's little girl is suffering.
Yeah.
And the answer to like, the help is there. It's there. And all that needs to happen is the government needs to get off his ass and do something about it. That's it.
And he won't. And he won't, because he's a chicken. I mean, that's basically it. He's a non-believer. He has no courage on it. It's well, people need to keep calling. People need to show up.
Yeah,
show up.
No, and that's
the
only thing they're
going to
respond
to. The day of that protest, when everyone gets there at the state house, when they continue into the state house, you march right in there into his office.
Yeah,
that's what I hope it ends.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
absolutely. And that's the thing. I mean, just
I can't be there that day. I don't think.
Leave all your metal objects at the door, though, because you'll all have to go.
You're
going to
be there, right?
I'll absolutely be there.
I don't think
100%.
I can be there. I think I'm working.
I'll be there. I'm taking the day off.
A lot of sick days. But we should. I don't even know what time it is. I threw away my stuff when I had my temperature. Who's watching the show today?
We still got about 10 minutes.
No,
like
he's flashing hands.
8 minutes. We got like 8 minutes.
Mike.
Yeah.
All right.
We got 8 minutes. But yeah, so Nikki Smokes or Nikki Snow, who also spoke at this press conference, is going to be on EMF later on tonight after Smoking in the Girls' Room.
I'm gonna have to come back. Yeah,
is it?
They don't escort me out of the building. I really trashed the place today.
Yeah, he threw
Frank's
stuff around.
Bruised.
I'm fine.
It's like gonna be an NFL incident.
You know, we're just gonna.
Maybe I'm really gonna get in trouble now because I'm kidding about spousal abuse. That's not
spousal abuse.
I'm not really. No. I didn't do that. You're like my spouse. He's my fake spouse. All right. But.
Oh, man, so I think I just had my first taste of the ugly side of this business.
Is that the couch? What?
That's from Handsome Boy Modeling School.
I miss that one.
Yeah. It's a song called Modeling Just Sucks.
I miss a lot of those.
Yep. No, Handsome Boy Modeling School is good stuff. But what's the name of the show that Nikki's going to be on? It's Dab?
No, it's Dab Wars tonight.
Oh, that's like the...
That's not the show.
Dream...
Yeah. No. No?
No?
You still got it wrong. You're close. Twisted Dreams.
Twisted Dreams.
Twisted Dreams Radio.
Cool.
And it's Dab Wars tonight. Yeah. And smoking in the girls' room, this has got a lot of girls over here.
Yeah. They're talking about the student debt crisis tonight, right?
I think so, yeah.
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 Pretty cool, too, speaking of student debt, strike debt.
You know who else? Yeah, speaking of strike, you know who else is, I heard, coming on the show today? Jillian Mason.
Yeah.
From Massachusetts. I can never say.
Jobs for Justice?
Yes. Massachusetts.
Massachusetts.
Jobs for Justice. She's awesome. She just got arrested, too, a little while ago.
Nice.
For fair wage for fast food workers.
Fast food workers, yep.
In Boston. They hauled her away, the Boston police.
That was nice of them.
Yeah. So, maybe we should just... We got it out on medical marijuana. It's just disgusting.
Yeah.
Call the governor. Show up at his office.
Yeah. And come out to the protest if you can.
Which is October what?
I'm looking that up
now. It's like a Tuesday upcoming. You'll find it. It's all over Facebook.
Certainly.
The link will be on our Young
Yeah,
Jerks
we'll put
page.
The link up. It's hashtag unacceptable if you want to post on Twitter or Facebook.
You'll find it.
Or whatever other social media outlet accepts a hashtag. It's hashtag unacceptable. The 14th of October, starting at 11 in the morning, the protest in front of the Massachusetts Department of Public Health. And that is at 220 Washington Street in Boston. And then after some speakers and some standing out and things like that, I'm going to march to the State House and then march into the State House.
The governor's office.
And go directly to our governor's office and visit our representatives as well as our senators and explain to them exactly what's going on and ask them, you know, what they would do if they had a family member, a little girl in their family, a five-year-old little girl, a niece, you know, who had 20 seizures before 10 o'clock in the morning. And would they deny her access to effective, safe medical marijuana? And I bet you the answer is no.
I know, really. It's just disgusting. Disgusting. How do you let that happen? Especially after there's a law passed.
Yeah.
And it's been almost 2 years. And the people that were working with you, the patients that were working with you that passed the law, and you told, oh, just be quiet, go along with us. If you work with us, we'll help you out.
Yeah.
Those people have even turned on you now.
Well, that's the thing, you know, and it's like they dragged the MASH patients along, you know. They dragged them along and dragged them along, and then the MASH patients in turn, you know, dragged their constituency along as well. And now it's like, you know, we're just going to put it all out there. We're going to put it all out there. The fact that, you know, no more being patient. We're done. Being patient.
All right. Yeah, that's it.
That's what we're going to leave it. We're the Young Jerks.
Yeah, we're on WEMF radio.
For now.
For now. For this moment.
We got Smoking in the Girls' Room coming up next.
Yeah, keep it here. Keep listening.
Keep it locked.
Smoking in the Girls' Room coming up next. And I'll be back a little later, maybe, on, what is it?
Twisted Dreams Radio. And for this night's session, it's called Dab Wars.
It sounds like that's what I need, too, Frank. You know what?
Double dab a doos.
I'm going to be dabbing it up tonight.
A little dabble, do you?
So we'll dab you later.
That's right.
We are the Young Jerks.
And we'll be back next week.
Maybe.